All right, how do we want to handle the opening?
Let Lana worry about it.
Okay.
Should we say, like, you know, we're on break for our D&D campaign, we're doing the Star Wars thing in the meantime, it's a miniseries?
We could say that, maybe.
So we are still under the stay-at-home order here in Ohio. D&D campaign is on a hiatus. It will come back, and if you haven't watched it, be sure to go back and check it out because it's some awesome stuff.
Wait, who's Josh, why are you here?
I'm here to DM for this particular game.
Yeah. Which means Rick gets to play.
Yes.
Special thanks to Josh because he's taking time to help DM this here so that we can have a fun story and whatnot. He also streams, right, over at Twitch, Josh902. He does his own D&D thing over there, which I've been a part of, which is fun, but it's been going on for a while now.
2 years.
2 years.
Nice.
It's really fun.
So indeed.
Make sure you guys check that out.
So our adventure, we're going to be playing the Star Wars 5th edition, which basically takes Dungeons & Dragons 5th edition and slaps Star Wars paint all over it.
Yes.
And we're going to be playing as clone troopers, which, if you're not watching our reactions, Calvin and I are reacting to Star Wars The Clone Wars for the first time, and Aaron and Eric are reacting to the newest season.
Yep.
If you want to join our army, we have Star Wars Clone Wars shirts.
Maybe not right now.
Not right,
not right now.
Because the store is down. But in the future, when things open back up and everything is back to normal, maybe check it out.
So I suppose without further ado,
as we begin, the much loved Star Wars theme starts playing.
Ba-da.
And you see the title of Star Wars come down over the backdrop of space. As you scrolls up, you see the subtitle of Riptide, and under that, you see the series name of Wave Squad.
Wave Squad!
And as the crawl continues, it says, War! The Republic is on the defensive after a series of separatist attacks strike deep into their territory. A Republic capital ship, the Basilisk, is currently engaged in a losing battle with the Confederacy's own ship, the Veracity, over the planet of Tanab. In a desperate attempt to turn the tide, the brave Jedi Knight Soro Taa and his Padawan, Karina Satala, lead an elite force of clone troopers under the command of Captain Harbinger into the jaws of death once again. And the camera slowly transitions down into what you see is the Republic capital ship currently engaged with the Separatist capital ship. We zoom in on two pods that have been jerry-rigged, and we zoom in on the on one of the pods that's kind of being fired at as we zoom in on Wave Squad. Wave Squad, what do you look like?
Go, Captain.
Rick, stand
well,
up.
We all look very similar.
Exactly the same.
Exactly.
I'm in some lighter armor myself. I imagine, Rick, if you start off and we can go through which each of us kind of have as armor-wise, because some of us have a little heavier than others as well, right?
Yeah, sure. So I'm a captain. I'm in very light armor. I have a blaster pistol. I've got a few grenades. I also have a deck of cards that I am constantly shuffling whenever I'm not doing anything else.
I am a Reaper. I am a sniper. I have my rifle with me. I also have two blaster pistols on my side. And I'm also wearing a very light, it's like a fiber armor.
I am Shell Shock. I'm in heavy armor. And I specialize in different types of ammo. And I also have gotten a little too close to a certain amount of explosions. So I'm pretty quick to anger. And also, I have a couple screws loose.
I am Drillbit. I am in medium armor. I have various tools in sticking out of my backpack and belt. And I am leaning on an astromech droid.
Well, excellent.
Does the astromech droid have a name?
Yes. R33K.
Reek?
Oh, yes. My God. That's amazing. What does he sound goodness. Like, Calvin? Does he have, like, an R2 sound? Is he more Goldie? Or is he, like...
like that bird?
That's so funny.
Oh, Lord.
Tell me what's your trooper name?
Drillbit.
Drillbit. We're under command, or we're under the command of General Soro Ta and Commander, what was the Padawan's name?
Karina Satala.
I don't know what rank I am. I don't have a rank.
You don't have a rank.
I don't know what my rank is.
You don't have a rank, trooper.
I should say, in this pod currently, there's Shellshock, Drillbit, Harbinger, Reaper, and the Astromech droid, mm-hmm. as well as the Padawan Karina Satala. This is all part of General Sorota's grand scheme, as the Basilisk is in a losing effort right now. It is being hammered by the Veracity. In a desperate attempt to stage a counterattack, the idea is for you guys to infiltrate the other ship. These pods have been jury-rigged with gigantic lasers and saws to kind of saw into the separatist ship. And there are two different pods, and this pod is you guys, and in the other pod is the General, Sorota, and his clones that are currently with him. Cleaver, Trickshot, Chase, Magic, and Coil are all in the other pod. And as you're closing, and you're and they're trying to shoot you down, there's lots of blaster fire incoming, but
incoming! Because of the...
you're fine. Interrupt wherever you want to. It's fine. Because the ship, these are so small that you're able to evade most of the blaster fire coming in at you. There's shots here and there, and Satala looks over at you and says, I can't believe he talked me into this. Can you believe he talked us into this? She's looking over at you, Shellshock.
Yes, Commander. The General's always having these great schemes. I can't wait to see how many droids I get to bust today.
Yeah, great. Great. as she says the great, great, you hear the General over come over comm static, and he says, have no worries, Padawan. But trust in the Force. It'll see you through. And Satala answers back and says, you weren't supposed to be listening. And right about that time, you close with the Veracity, and your pod slams into it with a loud thud and banging noise.
Fear not, men. We are about to ride the waves of fate. This is our oar. He shows the blaster pistol. This is our rudder. He points to his brain. We will survive this day.
And on that, the lasers fire up. And after a good few solid moments of tension, a giant person-sized hole is cut into the Veracity. The metal gives way, and you pour into an empty room. In the middle of the room, you see a large blue holographic table. Currently showing the battle before you, and I'm going to go ahead and switch the map over to the battle map.
Ooh. Just for some context, do I know Sorota? I'm assuming he's a male Jedi mm-hmm. master.
He's a male Jedi.
Human?
He is a human. He's an older, like, human.
Okay, and then Karina, also human, female?
Yes, yes. Okay. So you find yourselves in this room. It's kind of jostled from your rather dramatic entrance. You made a hell of a lot of noise when you came in. And in front of you, Shellshock, you see a large blast door that is currently sealed shut. What do y'all do?
Open the blast door.
All right, well, I mean, I assume we roll in, and I'm going to find somewhere to put my back that is not exposed, do a quick survey of the room, and then see where everybody has posted up.
Reaper's going to roll in with his dual pistols. It's going to be, he assumes, shorter space that he needs. But then I'll assume position over by the blast door so that we can try to get it open.
Yeah, I'll try to be near the blast doors so people can see me.
The Padawan also takes up position around the blast doors. Who's going to attempt to open?
Reaper's going to move behind this table.
All right.
Pull out his sniper in case he can take shots down the way. Shellshock, what do you see with the door?
I'm going to look and see if I can see some kind of opening mechanism next to the door, or if it's going to automatically open if I step in front of it.
Yeah, there is a mechanism on the side of the door. It looks like some sort of computer or data, like computer thing in the wall.
All right. I'm going to do a quick tuck, roll over to the side where I can reach it. I'm gonna say, here we go, boys. Make a fist and hit the button.
It bings, and nothing happens. It blinks red and says, access denied.
Damn.
Well, that was anticlimactic.
All right, I'm gonna use a combination of sage advice, master's advice, and lingering advice. And I'm gonna give everyone a +4 to their technology checks for the next hour.
Ooh. Gotcha.
Okay. Drill a bit. Do you think you can get this door open?
Let me give it a try.
Give me a technology roll.
All right.
All right, I'll move out of the way, let Drillbit get close, and post up over his shoulder.
With your plus four, that'll be a 28. You've done this a million times. And it opens immediately into a room of... Yeah, that's going to be initiative.
Clankers!
Exactly.
Dang it, I missed out. I was going to.
So what you guys want to do is click your tokens and then click initiative. Exactly like that. Awesome. And all I will roll for the clankers.
We have plenty of ammunitions and ordnance. Don't hold anything back. I can't get mine to work.
Click the word initiative, not the number.
There you go.
Jesus, damn. Rick, can't get it to work.
Huh, natural 20.
Fate is with me this day.
I actually have a house rule for rolling natural 20s on initiatives, and that is you will get an extra action.
Ooh.
On top of what you would regularly get. But let me roll for the clinkers. Even with your natural 20, unfortunately, one of the droids is going to go first. And he is going to move forward. Let's see. I'm trying to see who's got shots on. Got shots on everybody. He's going to take a shot at you, Shellshock.
Bring it on.
Two wrist heavy blasts clanker. Coming at you. A natural one, which is appropriate. And a...
Uh-oh.
20 even. What is your AC?
Oh, my AC is a 17.
So it hits.
Mm-hmm.
You take... Wow. You take 7 points of energy damage.
Gah!
And his other blast goes wide, searing just past you, Drillbit. And it makes you rather uncomfortable. It's a little close there, man.
Cover!
Now I'm really angry.
Captain, it is your turn.
Ah. Shell shock. Shake it off.
Always do, Captain.
I want to roll a d6.
Yep.
I'll just roll this. So a 6. So you get 10 temporary hit points, shell shock.
Ooh.
As I use a bonus action to bolster you.
So I just what do plus 10 on this?
Oh, yes.
So,
and temporary hit points can go over your maximum hit points as well.
Correct.
And they're taken out first.
Wouldn't be the first time they've rung my bell, sir. A couple times, actually.
So can I peek around the corner and fire at that B2 droid? Or no?
Yeah, you can. You can peek around.
So if I have two actions, the first one is I'm going to use Distracting Strike to try and hit it with my blaster.
Which B2 are you shooting?
Superiority die, huh? The same one that shot against Shellshock.
Okay.
The B2.
Or this two.
B2 on the southeast corner.
On the right. Yeah.
Unfortunately, a 9 is going to miss as your shot goes a little bit wide.
All right. Then I'm going to use my second action to do a commander strike and order Shell Shock to fire instead. And if he hits, he will deal an extra 2 damage.
All right.
Okay. Well, don't gotta tell me twice. I pull up my assault cannon and let her rip. That is presser, right? That's all I gotta
do. You do? Yeah, that's all you gotta hit. Do, 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 do. A 14 just hits. Roll your damage, Shell Shock.
Ah!
For a total of 10 as the energy damage crashes into the very body of the super battle droid, and it takes down a good chunk. It looks like you hurt it pretty bad.
Then for my second bonus action, because I get two because of my something ability. I'm going to use critical analysis on Reaper. I am giving you critical analysis, which means... So you can basically expend that analysis to get a one-time bonus of +4 to either an attack roll, an ability check, or a save.
Okay. To the next attack ability check. Okay.
Yeah, so you have it, and whenever you choose to expend it, you can then apply it. So it doesn't have to be your next attack roll. It's just your next attack roll after you choose to expend it.
Okay.
And that's it for me.
You don't want to move at all? You're good?
Yeah, I'm good.
All right.
I get safe back here.
Just kidding. I mean, so, yeah. That's the end of your turn, and it's one of the droids' turn. And he says, heal the clones. And the other droids reply, roger, roger. And he opens. He's going to open fire on... Oh, damn. These guys got traits. I forgot. And he's going to try to shoot Shell Shock again. He's like right there, front and center. Mm-hmm.
Go on, I can take it.
14 to hit you, Shell Shock. I think that's a miss.
Miss.
His shot goes wide. And that is his turn.
These clankers can't hit anything.
Drill bit, you're up.
I'm leaning against the edge of the blast door. Mm-hmm. And I raise my ion carbine to the B1 that just fired.
That one,
and
gotcha.
I will fire at him.
You will, I'm pretty sure, kill this guy. Roll your damage. That definitely hits. You know from your experience on the battlefield that these things are vulnerable to ion damage.
Exactly.
And as such, he crumples in a heap as you're, as it just fucking,
I got your back, Shell Shock.
Shocked up, yeah.
Wah!
It is the next droid's turn.
Does the droid hear?
Oh, yeah, that's
turn?
Right. Calvin.
I wasn't sure if it goes on Calvin's turn or if it has its own initiative.
Yeah, Calvin, it goes on my turn.
It goes on your turn. You got to give it orders. My bad. I hit the button. That's a bad habit I have, is I'll go to the next initiative before everything's done because I'm silly.
No, it's okay. He doesn't have the best AC, so I don't want to push him up too far. But I would like him to get into the action. Allies don't grant cover, so I can shoot through myself, right?
You can shoot through, and you
is
can
there,
move through.
Is there a wall there, and the doors are here? And here? Or is all of this wall? Door, rather.
In front of your token, in front of Shell Shock, and in front of the Padawan is all where the doors would be open.
Okay.
It's sticking out a little bit. You might have a little bit of cover there, but yeah, you can move through it if you need to.
Well, I was just wondering if he could stay here or... even move here and shoot the B2.
You can shoot and then move if you want as well. So if you want to take a shot there at anything out there, you can totally do that.
Yeah, I'll shoot at the B2 there.
Go for it. Roll an attack.
All right. He's going to be shooting with his blaster pistol.
He has a blaster pistol?
Yeah.
He has hands.
He doesn't do well, though.
No,
he's got clamps.
He rolled a 7. He misses.
You can pull out one of those things and hold a blaster.
It's happening on fire. Do that.
There are, side note, there are modifications where this thing could have 4 arms if it really wants to.
This will make a fine addition to my collection.
Unfortunately, what you hear is woo and a miss. So
he gets so
useless
excited.
Clanker.
He's not useless. He's on our side.
You want to move him up a real bit?
Yeah, I'll move him up to the wall there.
Just so I don't take a shot at him, which is what I was fixing to do. Drillbit, you got a droid pointing a gun at you. He's going to take a shot. Ooh, that might hit. A 22 to hit you, Drillbit.
Yeah, that definitely hits.
Oh, no.
I don't know of anybody on our team that wouldn't hit.
That almost hits me twice.
You take a total of 4 energy damage, Drillbit. As the bulk of your armor, you know, kind of deflects most of it, but, you know, it's a little bit more scorched than it was before.
Shake it off, soldier.
Just some scorch marks. I'm fine.
Don't want to be a shiny.
How mean do I want to be?
Oh, cool. You can hover over them in the turn order and see which one's going next.
Exactly. It should ping. I think it also pings on the map.
Yeah, mm-hmm. It does. When you switch it, it goes bong.
See if these guys survive the next round. It's going to take 2 shots at the actually, it's going to move up because this giant tank is in the way. And it's going to take 2 shots at the Padawan.
Look out, Commander.
almost as you say that, Satala pulls out her double-bladed lightsaber and deflects both blasts as they go wide.
Woo!
Her saber is a yellow color.
Nice.
Sounded like a lightsaber, that.
The last time I pulled my lightsaber out on camera, that sounds really bad, it made a really loud noise. Exactly. Mine's over there. This droid's gonna have a shot. He's gonna roll an acrobatics to go over this table. Let's see if he does it. Hey, he succeeds. Wow. I'm shocked.
I wanted to see the clanker fall.
And speaking of shocked, it's gonna take a shot at you, Shell Shock.
Shell Shock.
And roll a 2 and miss very badly. Oh my goodness.
Still a little unsteady from that leap.
Yeah, man. Like he's like slipping and falling and roger and all over the place.
Don't need to be a Jedi to miss that one.
It is the Padawan's turn. She's going to run out. Whoops. I screwed up the thing. Hang on. She's going to engage this battle droid. And I need to pull open her stats really quick. She gets one attack. And she misses. Somehow this droid takes a step back and Atala is quite frustrated by her wide miss, saying, blast. The master always did tell me to watch out for that backstep. Two more droid turns. We'll speed them up real quick. This one's going to take a shot at Shell Shock because he's still up there front and center, man. I'm pretty sure this misses. Does a 15 hit you, Shell Shock?
Miss.
Miss! That's his turn. This one's gonna come running forward and take another shot at Shell Shock. That definitely misses. Reaper, it's your turn.
Right. They can't hit me, boys!
Do I have an angle now on this one here from where I am? Or is this wall blocking me?
You'll have to take a step to the left.
Should I go there?
Yeah, now you got a sight on it. You can always measure as well with the ruler. Yeah, you got a shot now.
All right. I want to take my shot with my sniper rifle. So I'm going to roll off to the side, take aim at that B1. And not only am I going to take my shot, I'm also wanting to do penetrating shot, I believe.
Ooh.
Because it looks like these B1 units are lined up. So I'm going to take a shot through one and hopefully into the next as well.
All right.
Also, how does this work with my sneak attack? Yeah, so it would take 2 of my sneak attack rolls when I do this, and then the other one will take the 1. So let's see if I hit.
A 12 misses, unfortunate. Yes. Your shot goes wide. But don't forget your critical analysis.
I forgot. Yeah, what does that do?
It gives you a +4.
I should have used that. Can I use that still?
Go ahead.
You can use it after the roll, but before you know the result.
Eh.
All right. Well,
you can save it for your next go if you want, or we can use it now. It's up to you. I'll leave it up to you.
I'll use it.
All right. Roll your damage.
It hits? Okay. So it's going to be that plus...
Well, you kill the first one outright.
All right. And then my sneak attack on the other, which would take... It'd take 2 sneak attack damages, I believe. So 7 damage to the other one?
You get a 2-for-1. They're both dead.
Yes. Sweeper rolls to the side, takes aim, shoots through. It goes through one B1 into the other B1.
Fire.
For a fraction of a moment, there was a glint in your eye, but you're able to readjust. Shell Shock, you're up.
All right, so I've been shot at a bunch of times, both misses and hits. So I think I'm going to pull out an ion grenade from my belt and toss it. Right in the square between this B1 and B2 on the left.
Right here?
Right there.
Gotcha.
So, ion grenade.
All right. They have to make saving throws, and they have disadvantage on these.
All right.
Because they are droids. That's a failure. That is also a failure. The grenade explodes with an electrical lightning radius. You take out one droid and severely wound the other.
Eat that, Glenka! All right, well, that is my first action, but because I'm level 5, I get another action. So I am going to pull up the assault rifle, or assault cannon, and shoot at the B2.
Go for it. Ooh, a 23 hits!
Ooh, baby!
Nice. Roll that beautiful damage.
14. Ooh.
Jesus. No. Told you, dudes. Eric rolled really well on his stats. Oh, hits like a truck. it's wounded very badly. It's kind of wandering in circles going, Roger. It's still standing.
Was that guy?
Gotcha. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I think I just have the two attacks and that's it.
All right.
Fear not, Shellshock, you will have a third soon.
Yes. I can still do a movement now too, right? Because
you sure can.
I did kind of like jump forward, I guess, whenever I did the grenade, but I do want to not get in defensive position, but at the very least, maybe not be the absolute point of attack. Maybe I'll go and can I move and maybe back up the Jedi here?
You sure can.
I will do
you
so.
You have a lot of movement left if you want to do more than just like one step.
Okay.
Your speed's 30, so you can move. One square is 5 feet, so.
Gotcha. Okay. Yep. All right. Yeah.
5 squares left.
All right. Well, I will move up then to. Actually, I'm going to move up here. That way, I can maybe focus on this, but I don't draw the fire of the. B2.
There you go. Awesome. You notice as you get closer to that tube, Shellshock, just at a glance, that it is filled with something that is probably highly volatile.
Ugh.
Probably a bad idea to shoot at it.
All right, I'm going
or
to.
Take cover behind.
I'm gonna scream in excitement and hope that the rest of the crew understands why.
Shellshock, make sure that you keep eyes on that B2 so you can finish it off.
Yes, sir.
What's wrong with Shellshock over there? Why is he screaming like that?
does Shellshock have a shot on this guy?
Which guy?
I'm trying to click. It's ping. Not pinging.
If you don't have make sure hold. You have the select move. Pick. Click this one. There you go.
That was me.
Yeah. He's got a shot on. You got a shot on this dude. Technically, you got a shot here, but he would have some cover.
Yeah.
Well, you could blow that up.
Anyway, that's beside the point.
I don't know how much of a boomer it would be.
Big bada boom.
Those are large tanks.
If that was your turn, it is this droid's super battle droid's turn.
That's my turn.
He is going to whack the attempt to whack the crap out of this Jedi. Ooh, that hits. And that misses. The Jedi takes some damage. Not very much, though. It takes 4 damage. And that's his turn. Wabinga, you're up.
Okay. I still can't seem to ping.
The one at the very top that looks like a mouse pointer? There you go.
Yep. All right. So I want to put critical analysis on this.
This one?
This one.
All right. I'm going to put a little token on there. But you can see. I'll put the stop sign on it.
What does that do? Is it the same thing you gave me, right?
Yeah, but if I use it on an enemy, I get to attack them with my intelligence modifier instead of dex or strength.
Ah, okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's cool.
And I am going to try and fire with my pistol. So instead of the normal +3, this is going to be an additional +4, so that's a 19.
That, it hits, yes.
Oh.
It hits
one. He's already hurt a little bit. It might do something.
It stops going in circles and just stands there looking at you with a look of really, bro.
Ow.
You got anything else?
Well, I'll go ahead and use a second bonus action, I guess, to give critical analysis to let's give it a shell shock.
That means you get a +4 on your next anything, pretty much.
Okay.
It doesn't have to be your next one.
Or the one you choose, correct.
How long does that last? Like an hour?
Dead?
An hour.
Nice.
Drillbit, you're up, because the droid that was next is destroyed. As is this one.
Alrighty.
All these iron grenades going off seems to have done something to my pistol. It's not shooting at full capacity.
Pushing up!
It's my controller. And it's broken.
I don't want to shoot this guy.
Go for it. Roll the attack.
With my ion carbine.
A 12 misses, I do believe.
Does it?
Okay. It do.
And I will move R3 up to here, and I will have him attack that guy.
Please, please kill it. Make it be so good. Oh, it misses.
Oh.
Most unfortunate, my friend. It is that droid's turn. You gonna take a shot at Astromech that just took a shot at it.
Uh-oh.
Little bit of droid on droid violence.
Oh, damn. I'm pretty sure both these hit. What's the AC of the droid again?
14.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Both those hit.
I wonder if I can bolster a droid.
I don't think it works morale. The same way.
He takes 12 energy damage from both attacks.
Oh.
Is a big hit.
This is a Mercury all over again.
It says companion. Choose a friendly creature.
Yeah. But droid's a creature.
Is it? I thought
By the rules of the game, I'm pretty sure it is.
Yeah, cool. It would just... Yeah.
If it wasn't, I would rule that it was. So there you go.
Alrighty. Fair enough.
But I don't like the droid, so...
Well, fair enough.
Yeah, but you like Drillbit.
Drillbit likes the droid. Does he like Drillbit then? Maybe there's some tension.
It's not about like. We're brothers.
That's fair. It is this droid's turn, and seeing Shellshock push up on it, it's gonna pull back a little bit. Oh, Shellshock, you can see down this hallway a little bit now. Mm. Actually, you can see down the whole hallway.
Oh, okay.
I need to zoom out.
Let me go ahead and feel that.
Woo!
Wow.
Long it's a long hallway up ahead.
You can totally
see it.
Looks clear.
And this droid's gonna take a—he's gonna back up and take a shot at you because it's stupid and thinks it can hit you. 16 to hit.
Miss.
That?
Damn. That's a bad droid. The Padawan is gonna make an attack against Mr. B2. And hit and roll a lot of damage for this lightsaber. I'm just gonna roll it in the chat because I don't care if you guys see friendly rolls. Damn!
Woo!
Smokes that droid. Dead as can be. Chopped up in little bits. Satala looks relieved and then she moves over to next to Drillbit and starts to cover your backside with her lightsaber. Reaper, you're up.
Reaper's gonna. After taking out these two droids, he looks at the farthest one, heading towards the hallway here, and he's going to take aim at it with his sniper and fire.
Fire. 14 hits. Roll your damage.
Yes, good. All right, so there's going to be that.
It's dead.
All right, I don't even need my sneak attack. Another clanker down.
Do you want to move?
I don't know.
Here's a tip for you, D&D dudes out there. Plan your move on other people's turns.
I don't really want to go. I'll go over here.
Alright. Okay. Hide in the corner. Gotcha. Shellshock, you're up.
Alright. I am going to rush over right next to this B2.
Oh, Lord.
Pull out my vibro sword. Shink! And go for the strike.
16 hits. Jesus Christ.
Plus 8.
Cut him down to size.
I'm going for the head.
You take that and a few other pieces with you.
Oh, I love this thing.
That is the last bad guy. Combat is currently over.
You know, Commander, the General showed me a couple moves with this, too.
Well done, team.
All right. Exemplary work.
Let's look around the room and see if we can disable any security.
Shellshock, why are you so happy over here?
I'm going to take out my blaster pistol and just hit against the tank. Oh, I think this is explosive, sir.
Satala's eyes widen as you do this.
I get you.
Careful.
Sorry, Commander.
I'm going to move over to the console and see if I can get any useful data.
This console appears to be linked into the doors in this room. You know, you guys take notice of four doors that are in this particular room. The readout suggests that this is some sort of maintenance room, and the doors to the storage units on the walls are currently locked. It also has readouts on the tubes. It is fuel, which is kind of being, there's like large tubes that run up into the ceiling that run to different parts and areas of this particular part of the ship.
Okay.
I'm just going to cover down the hall, look, make sure there's nothing coming.
There does not appear to be anything going on. You took them by surprise. There's not very much, even though you made a loud bang when you joined the party, everything in here was sealed up tight, so.
Drillbit, you should check on your droid.
Yeah, I'm going to meet him over here, and I'm going to use powers. Repair droid.
Commander, this is fuel. Perhaps this could be used to take down this ship. Shellshock, don't you have a few explosives?
More than a few, sir. All right, you're not, sir.
I can be.
Our objective is to destroy the ship. Is that what our objective was, or?
The objective is to try to do as much damage as you can inside.
Yeah, disable us because it's attacking.
It's a very dangerous. The basilisk is currently getting hammered really bad. So, your main objectives are: you recall the general saying to disable any guns that you might find firing on the ship. Create as much havoc as you possibly can to try to stop the ship inside. And at the very end of that list is to escape, but the odds of escape are very slim. So you have to be careful with how much damage you do if you want to try to make it out alive.
Gotcha.
Satala, Reaper, and Shellshock. Shellshock, you know explosives, and Reaper, you know ship stuff. While there is fuel and it is volatile in these containers, there's not enough here to necessarily blow up the entire ship or disable it. But it can do some damage if you set some bombs in here, to maybe to timed explosives, so you have time to kind of get out of the way. However, Shellshock, you realize that if you do this, you might block off your only escape route back onto the pod to escape.
Gotcha.
That pod is also the escape route then?
At the moment, it is.
We can use it to get out of here?
Yes.
Okay. Captain, this will go boom, but not the boom we need.
I kind of figured that. We'll leave the disable one to drill bit. Shellshock, you're on Havoc.
Yes, sir.
Let's move up. Every second we take is more lives lost.
Satala, who's been quiet for most of this time, steps forward. And her eyes kind of go distant for a moment. And she says, I feel cold. Do you feel cold?
Red hot. Blood still pumping.
No, Commander. Fights against clankers always gets me going.
Gets you going.
I don't know. There's got to be a word I want.
Okay.
I've got temperature control.
They don't really waste money heating these hallways for clankers.
Over the comms, you hear General Sorota, Satala, do you feel that? And she responds, yes, Master. What can it mean? Sorota comes back in and says, nothing good. Did you all land safely?
Yes, so far, but I agree. Peril could be on the rise.
Keep your eyes open, Captain. I have a bad feeling about this.
You know, he always says that.
Cleaver, put that droid head down. We don't have time for your little games. And you hear the comm chatter cut off. You continue pushing forward.
Thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed this, make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out on the future episodes of this Wave Squad short playthrough. We're going to be doing it for a little while we wait to get back to our regular D&D content, which you don't want to miss when that comes back either. So subscribe. And if you get a chance, check out twitch.tv, Josh902. He does his own D&D over there as well.